pick is in, and they went Drew Lock.
There it is. The Mad Men finally did it. I actually like this a lot. 42 okay. overall. Look, Drew Lock, and again, I don't weight positional value. So for me, Drew Lock's only number 57 overall on my board. I got a round 2-3 grade on him. But you got your long-term quarterback. And you can go to Joe Flacco and say, we know we got you a tight end and an offensive lineman. We know that John Elway loved Drew Lock. Now they got him 42, which I never thought was going to happen. Now, he does need time to sit. His footwork is not in a great spot. It gets haphazard, it gets messy, and it leads to all kinds of mistakes. But in terms of player comp, there's some Derek Carr in his game. There's some Jay Cutler in his game. That's kind of what I think Drew Lock can be in the NFL. So he does kind of look like Jay Cutler too, I guess. So accuracy got better this year. That's a big key as well. So for the Broncos, you still get two impact players to help you right now, and you find your franchise guy. I'm a big fan of what Denver's done this year. I'm a really big fan.
So Tom's a big fan of it. So Tom, if you had to give it a grade, you think this is an A pick?
Well, I think it is. He might be a bust. He's got bust potential, and it wouldn't stun me if he isn't very good in the NFL. But 42 overall, after you traded down earlier, so you're losing a bunch of assets. You took two other good players first. I like it. Noah Fant, Dalton Reisner, Drew Lock. I mean, look, man, that's a hell of a haul. All those guys were really good value.
Well, Tom's given an A grade, and it looks like Tom, they also had Noah Fant, Dalton Reisner, like you said, and then they go Drew Lock, so that's pretty solid. Now, let's look at what happened here with the trade. So the Broncos, they traded up to that 42 pick, and the Bengals, Steve, they got 52, 125, and 182. So who, now that you see that, who do you think won that?
Pretty even, frankly. Maybe I don't think the Bengals wanted anybody. That's kind of the vibe I get there, but I think it's a pretty even trade, so I'd say mostly win-win there in the end.